Barbie, Queen of Stars, and this is Angel. We send you love. Welcome to your weekly horoscope. This week, there's a lot of activities in the world of the stars. It's amazing and liberating. And this week, the sun is in the sign of Libra, so happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Let's get ready for a big, big, amazing week with lots of action in the galaxy. All good for us. The moon will travel in the signs of Aries, Taurus, Gemini, and Cancer. The big, big news of this week, we have a big, unusual fourth bloody supermoon with a lunar eclipse in very honest Aries that can be seen in the eastern US, Europe, Middle East, Africa. It has a very strong effect on revealing the truth about everybody in our own personal relationships, world affairs, the political arena. The drama train we have been experiencing is somehow now derailed. More truth is coming out, more justice, helping us to see the intentions behind people's words everywhere. Quite exciting. And on Wednesday, Mercury, planet of communication, will still be in its last week retrograde. It's going backward. It means redo, revise, relook at things, and it will meet up with the cool Libra sun, and that's good, being therefore closest to the sun this year. It will be clearing the air and give us great opportunities to see things in less emotions, more clearly, more grounded. A good week also to make peace and resolve conflicts and shoot towards the better good of all. Trust me, by the next few weeks, sanity will be slowly restored. Ta-da! Peace and love to all. Libra, let me start with you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Beautiful sign of love and peace. The lunar eclipse in your relationship sector can make you a little sensitive, but the sun in your sign improves your state of mind and confidence. Your energy is definitely higher, you're more in the flow. A good time to catch up on important projects. Hope is there. The key to your success is to keep your balance between your personal life and career. You may want to be more personal, don't. Keep up with the career. And somehow you get a clearer picture of where you stand in the future about your highest destiny. So believe in miracles. And if it's your birthday on the weekend, celebrate grandioso. It's a new beginning. Your magical color, red, lucky numbers 3 and 21. Scorpios, the lunar eclipse moon in your work sector brings positive breakthroughs in career or some answers of where you should be going. Saturn, now in Sagittarius in your second house, clears the air and gives you more answers and make you more strong. More than ever, you believe in what you do and you're doing, and it's showing. Trust your judgment and your hunches in all your negotiations and decisions. The good news, you do see the light at the end of the tunnel. After the rain, the sunshine. Either way, your determination, expertise, and patience really impress people. And on the weekend, you will feel very proud of who you are. As I told you last month, Scorpio Hillary Clinton is getting back on track. Her Chinese sign, the invisible boar, is pushing her to the top, the presidency. There's nothing you can do about it, and it's all good because she is on the right side of history. And there's another Scorpio, Union Buster Scott Walker, that dropped out. Well, in my opinion, he had a good choice. He's a goat, there's a goat here, and he had a nice Jupiter return. I think it was a mistake. And he will regret it in October, especially at the end of October. But since he is on the wrong side of history, maybe it's karma at work. If he was my client, I would advise him not to do this, not to quit now, wrong time. Mercury retrograde, the eclipse, wrong timing, but it's okay. Another Scorpio, well, Bill Biden. Well, no, he won't run. Of course he won't. Although he does have a fabulous chart, he has a lucky, lucky, lucky Jupiter, and he has good stuff, but Saturn is saying strongly on his ascendant. time to go back to really spend time with your family. And it's all good. Your magical color, blue, lucky numbers 4 and 22. Sagittarius, the super moon in fire and creative sector brings you popularity. People applaud you. You also get questions and answers about your life's highest purpose. Awareness, enlightenment, love could flirt with you if you're single, and you can make a decision about if a partner is good or not for you this week. Look at the bigger picture, reinvent yourself. The good news, your imagination is overflowing and you're very optimistic about your future and nobody's stopping you. Listen to other people's ideas. On the weekend, you're actually very psychic. Guess who is the lucky, fabulous Sagittarius Taurus? Famous with a rising moon in Aquarius, of course. The fabulous Pope Francis. I like him. And somehow, he is definitely on the right side of history. He's a mold breaker, Moon Aquarius. I predict that in time, he will push for the right to use contraception. Embrace the gay community and welcome women in the church. He's gonna do it. Isn't Jesus all about unconditional love? I think he will. He's the one. Your magical color, Sagittarius, fuchsia, lucky numbers 5 and 32. Capricorn, the eclipse in your home sector brings you new awareness about your needs in personal life. Are you happy? If not, make the necessary changes. Make a fresh start. Love yourself. In career, you attract new opportunities to make more money and the chance to express your talents. Dance to your own tune, but handle other people with fairness and a smile. Make sure to take good care of your health because you have a lot to do and you'll be quite busy for the rest of the year. And in love, be kind and fair to yourself and to others. On the weekend, take it easy, meditate. Aquarius, Cancers will help you, and somehow famous Capricorns in the news right now, Tom Cruise and also Rand Paul, nomination, not in the stars, I checked it out. Your magical color white, lucky numbers 6 and 33. Aquarius, the eclipse in your communication sector could shake things up a little bit, but it's all to help you to be more powerful. Time to clear the air, to know where you stand, to know who are your friends, and take a deep breath and somehow move towards the stars and just make things happen. You have a green light this week. In career, you are more in the flow, and somehow your courage and perseverance and knowledge brings success. Ask questions, and don't concentrate too much on details, just go for the bigger picture, and if you can, wait for next week when Mercury goes frontwards to make a final decision. On the weekend, you can read people's minds. Woo! Your magical color, mauve, lucky number 7 and 34. Pisces, the eclipse in your money sector brings a change, of course, in career and finances. You are a magician. You pull the rabbit out of the hat somehow. In health, it's more stable. Family situation also in the flow. In career, associates and co-workers would love to help, so ask. The focus is on really pushing on your goals. Are you happy with the lines of work that you're doing with your profession? If you don't, well, do something about it. Be daring and do what it takes to reach your goals and to be the best you can be. On the weekend, people, share some psychic stories with you that will inspire you. Leo, Virgo are definitely generous with you. Your magical color, pink, lucky numbers 8 and 44. Aries, wow, the eclipse, supermoon in your sign, you are the chosen one. It brings a big shift of energy for the better, and that's for the next 6 months. Suddenly you feel different and you want to make many changes in your life. I like it. Go for it all. It's all new and change is the name of the game. Justice is in the air, so take charge of your destiny. You can overcome any challenges. You are now very aware of who you are and many people are willing to help. Follow your hunches in career and love life. In travel, well, that would be nice. If you feel like you want to travel, do that the next month. It will do a world of wonders for you. On the weekend, happy reunions and victory awaits. Guess who is a famous Aries tiger? The soldier Bao burned down. Well, the truth came out. It turns out that he is innocent. Do you think that Fox Virgo Bill O'Reilly and shameful Gemini Trump will apologize for calling him a traitor and a scum of the earth? I don't think so. What happened with that fact checking in the news and in the politics? No more fact checking before you accuse and judge people? Glad the truth came out and that Virgo will finally go free. Ta-da! Karma at work. Your magical color orange, your lucky number 6 and 24. Taurus, this is a memorable week. The eclipse in your spiritual house brings a feeling of invincibility. Career and money picture, definitely more on the flow, but need your attention. Someone close may also demand some advice, so be there for them. Sharing and helping other people, very rewarding. A good time to take the lead and take care of business in career. In love, follow your hunches. On the weekend, do something very nice just for you. Virgo, Cancer, care. Your magical color green, lucky number 7 and 43. Ta-da! Gemini, this powerful eclipse in your social sector helps you see the truth about the way you think and who you are and other people and what you're trying to accomplish. Like, it's becoming clear. It's some kind of what goes around comes around kind of week, bringing either sad sudden endings or exciting beginning. Your great intelligence and your sense of fairness will help you see the light. A good time to reinvent yourself and to be the best you could be. In love, generosity and forgiveness await. On the weekend, just cheer up and just have fun with life. More good news! Shameless Gemini Trump's balloon is evaporating slowly. Nomination, not in the stars, sweetie. I dreamed, you wouldn't believe what I dreamt, that he wanted to send back the Statue of Liberty to Paris, to the French people, and replace it with his own statue. Bet he would if he could, but he won't. That's so funny. Your magical color orange, lucky numbers 8 and 44. Ta-da! Cancer, the super eclipse moon in your career sector heightens your sense of destiny and purpose. The focus is on breakthroughs, taking action, unexpected surprises at work, and in health too, you're doing better. Healing, show business, publishing, public relations, being on stage, all favored. There could be some good negotiation with partners that will make you feel very good. Just push on your dreams. It's time for you now. It's time and don't miss the boat. On the weekend, it's time to really spend special, wonderful closeness with your family. Taurus and Leo really care. Famous Cancers, Lindsey Graham and George Pataki. Nomination, not in the stars, sorry. Your magical color, lilac, lucky numbers 9 and 36. Leo, this is a powerful week. The super eclipse in your karmic sector changes you forever for the better. What you were dreaming about is finally unfolding. Make sure to take care of your health, to be fit, go to the gym, eat good stuff. Make sure also to be your best, lose your weight. If you have a problem with this, get rid of it. And also go for beauty treatments. In career, somehow your leadership qualities are very, very, very strong. You make a difference everywhere and in other people's lives too. It's an ideal time to heal and to move forward. With family, you are doing better and better. On the weekend, get ready for a very good relationship with your parents, especially your mom. Let's congratulate the famous super Leo snake, Viola Davis, that won the Emmys. She made history as a black woman, and I loved her speech, didn't you? So congratulations. Your magical color gold, lucky numbers 1 and 10. Virgo, Virgo, the supermoon eclipse in your shell resources sector make you stronger and brave. Jupiter on your sun protects you no matter what you do. You have the ability now to express yourself and make the necessary changes to turn things around everywhere in your life. Honesty, cooperation, diplomacy are the magical words of the week. In career, you get a second chance and the support you need, just when you need it. On the weekend, spiritual moments await. Your magical color turquoise, lucky numbers 2 and 11. Here's your wisdom affirmation of this enlightening week. Let's take advantage of the energy of this very liberating super eclipse to see the truth about ourselves and other people's motivations. Let's choose love over hate, truth over propaganda. Embrace our differences and make good choices for the better good of all. What goes around, comes around. Love you guys, and don't forget to wear your glasses. It's eclipse time. Have fun. We're all growing up for the better good. Magical.
Tell me, JoJo Astrofoni.